Hey there, welcome back. We have completed our C++ base character class, and so now we are ready to move on and extend that in Blueprint to make our hero character, which is what we're going to do in this video. So let's take our base character, which is found under your C++ classes TwinStickShooter folder. We will right click on it and let's go to create blueprint class based on base character. Click on that and it's gonna ask you where it needs to be placed. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna cancel that real quick because I wanna be really careful about where I put stuff. I could always move it later, but I'm not gonna. Let's, in our content folder, let's right click and make a new folder, which I will call blueprints. And then once we do that, we'll right click and create a new blueprint class. Now let's select that folder and we're gonna call this the hero character. And create our blueprint class. Takes just a second to open up. And here we are inside the blueprint editor. And we have all of the different components that are native to a character. So we have our capsule component. We can see our character movement component. We can see our mesh. There's the arrow that always comes with it. And if we go under the My Blueprint panel and click on our little visibility dropdown here, we can click Show Inherited Variables. And there's our base character category, and there's health, and there's is dead. So that means our code is probably working. We can do one more check. If we pop over to the event graph up here at the top, let's just go to an area out here in the middle of nowhere, right click and type out calculate, and check it out. There's calculate health, and there's that incoming delta. So there is the functionality that we created in C++ exposed now as a blueprint node, which is pretty awesome. We don't need it right now though, so let's delete it. Let's go back over to the viewport and let's start turning this into our hero character. The first thing we're gonna do is grab the mesh component and we're going to add the skeletal mesh for our mannequin. That is the little Unreal mannequin character that comes with UE4. And we're gonna line him up with the capsule. It looks like my snaps are still set to 100 from earlier when we were building our level. So let's pull those back down to 10. And we wanna get his feet kind of lined up right with the bottom of the capsule. It doesn't necessarily have to be exact. You can always tweak it later. Now he is facing 90 degrees in the wrong direction. We want him to be facing down the X axis. So we're gonna rotate him 90 degrees. And yes, we all know about the arrow component. So if you're giggling about it, that's fine, but we're not gonna let it distract us. Okay, so now he's facing the appropriate way. Everything is good there. We have some other components though that we're gonna need for him to be like our actual playable character. He needs some stuff. What he needs most of all is a camera. And we're not just gonna add a camera. We're gonna set up a rig for the camera so that it can follow him in the way that we expect. Meaning that we want the camera to kind of fly above our character. We're gonna have kind of a top-down view, a little bit of an angle to it. And we want our character to be able to rotate independently of the camera. So when he's spinning around and looking for enemies to shoot, we don't want the camera to follow along with that rotation. So to set this up, let's go under Add Component, and we're gonna add a special component called a spring arm. Now a spring arm is a component whose really its job is just to maintain a fixed distance from whatever it's attached to, or try to keep its children at a fixed distance away from it. So we're gonna change some settings on it though. So by default, it inherits the pitch, yaw, and roll of its parent, the same as any other object that you parent to another. What we can do with a spring arm though, which makes it unique, is that we can turn off inherit yaw, pitch, and roll. So now it's not going to rotate along with the character. I'm also gonna turn off the collision test. If you leave that on and if any, like an enemy or a wall gets between your character and the camera, there'll be a little pop while the camera adjusts and we don't really want that, so we'll turn that off. At the end of the day, this spring arm is basically just going to have a camera attached to it pointed back at the character. So in a lot of ways, the spring arm is like a selfie stick, which is what I'm gonna name this. That'll help you remember what it's for. Now, we need to add our camera component. So let's add a camera, and we'll call it the hero cam, And we're just gonna drag and drop that right onto the selfie stick. And you can see, or onto the spring arm, we've only called it selfie stick. So now you can see that it gets attached right to the end of the spring arm. So with that done, just take the spring arm and rotate it up into the air. I like it at about 70 degrees, but your mileage may vary. If you want more precise rotation, you can turn off snapping. And then we're just gonna take the camera and I'm going to get the move tool out with W and just move it back a little bit, somewhere around 200 units, very much an inexact science though. Okay, so with that done, we have the components that we need for this to be used like our main character. Let's compile, let's save, we'll close out of this view, and then you can take your hero character and drag him into the view. And now if you take a look when you have him selected, you can see right down the camera's point of view, so you can get an idea of what the camera sees. And that's pretty much what we want. The nice thing about this, though, is that if you think it's too far away, which, by the way, I wouldn't make that judgment call based on a screen this size, but if you can tell, like, really obviously, if you're like, wait, no, I can tell just at a glance that's too far away or too close or whatever, you can make changes right here inside the blueprint view, and you can watch them update there in that little tiny preview window, which is kind of handy. So I'm still going to leave it pretty much back here somewhere, which is good. Compile and save. Now, we want to give our character a point in the world where he can spawn in. So let's go ahead and delete out this version that we've dragged into the world. Let's add a player start to our level. Now, you can find these under the basic category in the modes panel. And if you look, there it is. It's a player start. Just drag and drop it. And you'll notice there's a big blue arrow hanging off of it. And that arrow tells you the direction the player will be facing when they pop into the world. So I'm going to put it kind of close to one wall such that the arrow is facing into the majority of the world. And that should be good. Now, at this point, there's really not much else we could do without adding a game mode. So let's go ahead and get that out of the way, because this has been kind of a short video so far. As we mentioned in an earlier video, a game mode is really kind of your overarching set of rules. It's a class that will contain all of the rules for how your game is supposed to play. And we're going to create one so that it can inform our game that we want to play using this hero character. So let's right click here inside of our blueprints folder. Let's add a new blueprint class. And we will base it off of the game mode parent class. And there's this little description right there. So we'll add that. And let's name this Twin Stick Mode. Double click it. And right now we're gonna change very, very little about this. All we're gonna do is take our default pawn class and set that to the hero character. And that's it. We'll go ahead and compile and save. Now, the last thing we need to do is we need to make sure that our game is using this game mode whenever we play. And we're actually going to make this our default level while we're at it. So go under the Edit menu, jump down to your project settings, and let's start off over in Maps and Modes. So you can take your game default map. We'll just start at the top. So let's take the default map, click the drop down, and we'll set that to the arena map. And the editor startup map, and we'll set that to the arena map as well. Now under default modes, we'll take the default game mode and we will set that to the twin stick mode. And then you can override things if you want to, but we're not gonna do that. If you had a multiplayer game, make sure you also set it as the default server mode as well, but we're not gonna stress about that. So let's go ahead and close. And now if you hit play, you should see your character. And there you go, he's in the world. He looks ready to go. Now, you can't see this, obviously, because we don't have a camera, but I am moving the joysticks on my controller around and they're not doing anything yet. That's because we haven't hooked them into anything. That will be our next goal, so let's tackle that. That's gonna wrap things up for this video. Thanks a lot.